Ladies and gentlemen, the president of the Drama League and founder of the Directors Project, Julia Hansen.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Drama League's annual musical celebration of Broadway. Tonight, we are thrilled to pay tribute to one of the great ladies of the American stage, the incomparable CHITA RIVERA. Yay, CHITA! As president of the Drama League, it is my great joy to say thank you for being here, and thank you for your generosity. The dollars raised tonight will go to our Directors Project, a program that nurtures the next generation of theater artists. And there's a very important person here tonight who said to me recently, about two nights ago, you know, everywhere I look now, the hottest young directors are with a Drama League alumni at the end of them. Michael Mayer, Chris Ashley, Mark Brokaw, and John Rando. And we thank you for having invested in their futures, and the dollars raised tonight we hope will be for the next generation of artists to fill their shoes. So that's pretty great. Some of you know that I am now making my home with my husband in Colorado. And I say that to you tonight because I'd really like to tell you and introduce to you those people who are the visionaries and backbone of the organization today. Our executive director, Jane Ann Crum. I'm going to give you a few names. Let's do her separately, though. Jane Ann, thank you. Roger Danforth, who is the director of the artistic director of the Directors Project. Megan Coleman, who's our director of development, and also probably should get a small title tonight called producer. And Greta Rothman and David Koppel, who have just joined our staff. In addition to part-time people, we have an extraordinary core of volunteers. And you all have met earlier, but I would love another round of applause for Sheila Stevenson, Rochelle Ostrom, and Debbie Bancroft, our chairman. Thank you all.
Yay!
They were not introduced alphabetically, but for how many years they've been doing this. So the first one to join us was Sheila, and so on. One other person who is a new vice president of the Drama League and really has brought this team together tonight, I'd like you to join me in a round of applause for the beautiful Cece Black. Thank you, Cece. So the next thing I'd like to say is that we have a wonderful show once again, and that is due, of course, to the remarkable Albert Stevenson, our artistic director. Thank you, Albert. He's been assisted by Michael Leeds as director, Rob Bowman as musical director, Stephen Cole, again with us, doing books and special lyrics, Chet Walker, who is our choreographer, and there's some quite wild numbers, I think you'll enjoy those. In addition to that, our lights are again done by Joe Saint, his brother's in the audience, David Saint, who years ago actually was one of the first people to interview our directors, and he's now at the George Street Playhouse where CHITA has a new show. So we're happy about that. And yes, well, we hope you all go to New Jersey sometime soon. And then last of all, we have, I think it's Matt Bell, who's doing sound. I want to thank the actors who are generously giving their time and talent tonight, and to their unions who have allowed them to do that. And I would like to thank everyone, therefore, in the audience for making this a grand evening for the Drama League, and especially for CHITA. Thank you. On with the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, Alan Cumming.
Come on, babe, why don't we paint the town? and all that jazz. I'm gonna bruise my knees and roll my stockings down. And all that jazz. Start the car. I know a rookie spot where the gin is cold, but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all that. Dilly 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 day. Two cheetahs. Four cheetahs. It's now a sextet. Oh yeah. I like it. They like it. This six for one. Me and my cheetahs. My cheetahs and me. Each representing a show as you see. She's bye-bye birdie.
Chicago.
Bonjour.
Spider-Woman.
And the ring.
She made her mark in West Side Story.
We are the cheetahs.
You're gonna see my cheetahs.
She's the cheetahs. I love the cheetahs.
Oh, they're gonna shimmy till they got
Spider-Woman. That face. And the ring.
And all that jazz. Sure. And where's the Parker Tonys? Oh, these cheetahs are all phonies. Wouldn't you be cheetah too? She's all that.
Six may seem like fun, but very lonely ones.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's nice to have six cheetahs. But tonight, we celebrate the one, the only. Chita Rivera! Cheetahs in the house!
Rosa
Benita,
Nancy
Candida. Oh, what could be sweeter?
Look at our cheetah's hat. Look at our cheetah's hat.
Sing!
I haven't stopped dancing yet since we met for the first time. I haven't stopped loving you yet. Dancing yet with you, my only partner. I haven't stopped loving you yet. This is all I ever wanted to do. I've been dancing since I was four. So plant my feet on the floor and I get carried out.
Conchita Figueroa del Rivero Montestuco Florentino Caramajo de Fluente. That's a very nice Jewish name.
I used to jump around the sofa. Then there was a chair here, and there was the cocktail table here. And I used to jump, jump, jump. Well, I landed on the cocktail table one time and broke it. And Mother said, "That's it, out." And so she put me in a ballet school. I always say I got started because Mother wanted to save the furniture.
West Side Story established Rivera in the role of Anita. As a Puerto Rican American who spent her teenage years in New York, it was a part she seemed born to play.
I like to be in America, okay by me in America, everything free in America.
Through five decades, she starred in more than 25 musicals.
Oh, it's marvelous. It's marvelous. You see, I really get the idea that you're in love from the way you're dancing.
Who's dancing?
I, fine,
This is a little sign of forgotten your, forgotten your, forgotten your. This is a little sign of forgotten your.
CHITA RIVERA in Spanish Rose, CHITA.
Dime, Rosita Hernandez.
Take me to your bodega. You like me, yes? No? Maybe? Dije.
That I bought the bottom of the dress this year.
CHITA RIVERA!
It's still paying me. It's still forming me. I'm a lucky, lucky gal. I worked for it. And I intend to continue.
I haven't stopped dancing yet.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dick Van Dyke.
Chita Rivera. Just that name says everything there is to say about the musical theater. Chita, the high point of my career was standing in front of a Broadway audience with the most dynamic and electric performer ever to step out on the boards. To this day, I still remember it. Whenever something goes smoothly and evenly for me, I say, this is like dancing with Chita. I've never been on a stage with anybody more talented than you are. I think you are Miss Broadway and always will be. You're a loony, but I love you. We were great together except for one night when we came out for our big finale and we both fell down. Do you remember that? And then one time we went into our big kiss before our opening number, before our closing number, and her belt buckle and my belt buckle latched together. And we started to swing apart. We were locked in a death embrace. We couldn't get undone. We used to laugh a lot. I have to tell you that Chita loves to get downstage of you and make faces. And she tried, I was very green in those days, and she used to try and break me up. But not only do you deserve this honor, but they should name one especially for you and give it to you only. God bless.
Ladies and gentlemen, Elaine Stritch.
Oh, my God. Oh, the bright lights. Chita. What a joy it must be to sit at the Pierre Hotel after a little filet mignon. Pear glacé la and sit at a table and look up and have everybody for the next hour and a half talk about you. Especially the way they're talking about Chita tonight. Best thing that happened about Chita tonight, I was in Peter's office back as I've turned into a dressing room. They're just crazy about me back then. And one of the captains came in, and he's sitting down. He says, hey, who are they honoring? Now, I said, Chita Rivera. Oh, years ago, I see snowing like tonight. West Side Story I go to see. Oh, my God. Sexy. She was so sexy. And I said, being a close friend of Chita's, she still is. And he said, I'm going to go take a look. So if Jack comes up to you, Chita, and gives you the eye, it's my fault. Chita and I met, well, first of all, I think Chita was indirectly responsible for me going to London. I was in rehearsal for Company, and Chita was going to take me to lunch, and she drove by this, she was going to pick me up for lunch at the Alvin stage door, and, you know, there's a lot of restaurants around there. And Chita pulls up in a cab, and, get in. And I got in, and she said to the driver, across the street and step on it. And I decided it was time to get out of New York. He's so nervous. But anyway, our first encounter was in the national company of Call Me Madam. And Chita and I saw show business sort of together. It was early on for Chita and it was early on for me. And she was the lead dancer in the national company of Call Me Madam, and I had a whopper of a part, and we were both thrilled to death and scared to death. And We were so thrilled with the whole aura of show business and traveling and trains and hotels and, oh, my God. And big part, big time, you know, George Abbott, Mary and Joseph, we were all frightened to death. And Cheetah and I remember one time decided we didn't know whether to have two brandies or say the rosary. I mean, that's how confused you can get. But I settled that argument immediately. We had a wonderful time together. We didn't spend much time together, really. Actually, as I think about it now, I was in love with the leading man, and I don't know what Cheetah was doing. I just have suspicions, but I don't know. But anyway, I was attracted to Cheetah, big time. And I finally figured out what it is that makes you... I just wanted to get to know her better, and I wished her well, and I felt so close to her without knowing her at all. And I'll tell you what attracted me. Talent. That's what attracted me. God. So, enough said. I don't want to get certainly upset up here about that. But she's got it. She has a... I remember going backstage once when she was doing Spider-Woman. And I saw her in her dressing room. She didn't know I was out there. I was with Hal. And she didn't know I was standing outside. And she was getting ready to do that performance and talking and this and boom. And such tensity, not tenseness. It wasn't fear. It was, God, don't, Jesus, please, I got things. And then all of a sudden, my heart sinks. All of a sudden, onto the stage, and wow. It reminds me of that wonderful old Ziegfeld story about the Ziegfeld girl. It's kind of naughty, but I'm going to tell it. I'm not afraid to tell it. But it reminds me of what Cheetah did that night. There was previews, and there was a lot of... And it was the wonderful story about this. This is a true story. But the Ziegfeld girl that was at the top of the stairs with the birdcage on her head, ready to make her entrance. And the stage manager calls up to her. It was Stuttering Sam, actually, they used to call this girl. And she was up at the top of the thing, and her husband, who she didn't get along with at all, the stage manager said, Sammy, your husband's on the phone. And she said, fuck him, ah, pretty girl. It's a little taste of inside showbiz. One of the memories that I want to recall to Cheetah in Call Me Madam, we had a ingenue in Call Me Madam. Her name was Galina Talva. She was so Russian, it was embarrassing, I'm telling you. And she had one number that she sang, and I just want to remind Cheetah of it. Her cue into the song was like this. I love my people. The fair is open. Dance to the music of the ocarina. Who refuses? Wilhelmina? Now, you didn't think I was going to sing all of that, did you? No way. No, that's proof positive. I should never have been an ingenue. Anyway. All right, that's enough. We went through a lot together. We were in our early times in this crazy, wonderful, joyful, sad, terrifying business. And we got through it. And plenty more. After that, and the important part of this whole story is, we're here. God knows at least you were there, and you're here. Look who's here. She's still here. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. And now I want to introduce to you someone that Cheetah knows very well and will bring her back a big memory of our first show together. This young man opened in a show in the 50s in New York City opposite Ethel Merman, which in itself is not an easy task. And he was the juvenile in Call Me Madam. And he knocked this town on its and got notices the like of which I haven't read anything quite like them since, actually. I mean, he really knocked everybody's socks off. And he was thrilling in this musical. He was just great and launched a terrific career in show business. Ladies and gentlemen, looking so well that I can't get over it, Russell Knight.
Here we go. Thank you very much.
I hear singing and there's no one there. I smell blossoms and the trees are bare. All day long I seem to walk on air. I wonder why, I wonder why. I keep tossing in my sleep at night. And what's more, I've lost my appetite. Stars that used to twinkle in the skies are twinkling in my eyes. I wonder why.
You'll need analyzing. It is not so surprising that you feel very strange but nice. Your heart goes pitter-patter. I know just what's the matter, because I've been there once or twice. Put your head on my shoulder. You need some one who's older, rubbed down with a velvet glove. There is nothing you can take to relieve that pleasant ache. You're not sick, you're just in love. You don't need analyzing. It is not so surprising that you feel very strange
and
at night.
The trees are bare.
All day
long I seem to walk on air.
I know just what's the matter, because I've been there once or twice. Put your head on my shoulder. You need someone who's older. Twinkle. I'm
length of that
twinkling. Twinkling.
Yeah, that's it.
I wonder.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the original Maria of West Side Story, Carol Lawrence.
Hello, everybody. Tonight won't be just any night. Tonight there will be no morning star. Tonight. I'll see my love tonight, and for us, stars will stop where they are. Got a feeling there's a miracle too, gonna come true, coming to me. Around the corner, or whistling down the river. Come on, deliver to me. Could it be? Yes, it could. Something's coming, something good. If I can wait, something's coming. Don't know when, but it's soon. Catch the moon, one-handed catch. The air is humming, and something great is coming.
Maria, 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 Maria.
And suddenly my name will never be the same to me.
Maria, 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 Maria.
And suddenly I found how wonderful a sound can be. I feel pretty,
Maria,
so pretty. Feel pretty and witty and bright, and I pity any girl who isn't me tonight. See the pretty girl in that mirror there. Who can that attractive girl be? Such a pretty face, such a pretty dress, such a pretty smile, such a pretty me. I feel stunning and entrancing, like running and dancing for joy. For I'm loved by a pretty, wonderful boy. We'll find a new way of living. We'll find a way of forgiving. Somehow, somehow. Halfway there, hold my hand. and I'll take you there.
What a thrill to be here honoring Cheetah, my favorite person in the world. We have shared a stage together, and perhaps one of my favorite moments of all in West Side Story was the duet I got to sing with Cheetah, A Boy Like That. It was more thrilling than standing in a bunch of fireworks on the 4th of July just to stand opposite Cheetah in that number, and I loved every moment. As you probably know, we ended that scene in a veil of tears, the two of us. Cheetah was at the bottom of the bed sitting, and I was kneeling in front of her with my head in her lap. And she would pick up my shoulders and look me straight in the eyes, nose to nose, and she'd say, "Chino has a gun. He's sending the boys to get Tony." Except one night, she picked me up and she said, "Chino has a gun. He sent it to boys. He sent it to boys. He sent it to, he sent it to boys. He sent it to," and she couldn't get off that. You know how it is when you just can't let go of a word? I wanted to go, but I didn't do that. No, I didn't dare. We both of us broke up completely. And although the tears were still rolling down our faces, we were laughing. And she would say, "You would do it, Tony DiBernardo." And I'd say, "Yes!" It was awful. That wasn't the worst part. The worst part was that that night was Cheetah's wedding shower. And we all went to the shower, and everybody in the room did their version of, "He sent it to boys, he sent it to boys." We laughed until dawn. We were exhausted. And the next day, we went to the theater, and we shared the dressing room together, and Cheetah said from her room, "Would you like to go through that scene once?" I said, "No, I really don't. Let's just wait till we get on stage." She said, "I promise you, I will not stutter." I said, "That's fine with me." And so we got on stage, and now we're dripping with tears, and she picks my shoulders up, and she says, "Chino has a gun." I was gone. I saw her tonsils and her kidneys. I couldn't stop laughing. I fell right off her lap. By now, the kids are in the wings waiting to see how soon we'll break up. And the fourth night, we were devastating because this was our favorite moment in the show. Ruth Mitchell came to our dressing room. And she opened the door. I said, "Ruth, please don't holler at us because we are in pain. We can't stand that we're breaking up in this. We don't want to do it. We're trying to get out of it." She said, "No, that happens all the time. You'll get over it, you know. Just in time, and I'm not here about that. The set won't work tonight, and the bed will probably come on, but the doorway won't. It's in two pieces, and we're having problems with it." And we said, "You might not have a doorway." They said, "That's fine. We can do that. That's easy." And so she kept talking, and finally she said, "That's your 15-minute call. Oh, by the way, Jerry Robbins is going to be in the audience tonight." Cheetah picked my shoulders up, and she said, "Chino has a gun. He's sending the boys to get Tony." There wasn't a pause. It was perfect. Cheetah had saved the day again, as she has saved my life so many times, off stage and on. We would spend so many hours together just laughing every weekend, wherever we could go to have fun, just to get away from the burden of the show and doing it. But Cheetah is the kind of friend who is beside you, no matter what happens. And the Lord never blessed me with a sister biologically. But I've been deeply grateful to him for giving me Cheetah, because you're the only sister I know, and I love you so very, very much. Thank you, Cheetah.
Please welcome the director of She Loves Me, The World Goes Round, Steel Pier, 1776, The Rainmaker, The Waverly Gallery, and opening on Broadway in April, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer, the respected, esteemed, and totally dignified, Scott Ellis!
Thank you. are so very few people that I would dress up in a tuxedo and come on stage in rollerblades, except for one. I met CHITA doing the Broadway show, The Rink, hence the skates. And it was a remarkable experience. It was my first big Broadway show, and it was Candor and Ebb and Liza and Rob Marshall and this Graziella and this incredible, incredible group. But what was the most remarkable thing was CHITA. And after working with her, I thought, and it didn't take long, it was like a couple days, and I thought, oh, that is what a star is all about. That woman represents what being a true professional is. And I think I learned more from her during that incredibly fabulous year than I have anything else. I used to sit backstage and watch her all the time. There were about six of us in the show, and we each, at one time or another, played women in the roles. And I played a woman named Sugar. Pretty damn cute, I might add. And Graziella, I had this nice pink dress. God, I was cute. And we were upstage. I was upstage of CHITA, something you never do when dancing. And I had the dress, and I was allowed to whip the dress. So I would whip that dress around while she was dancing. And she turned to me one day and she said, you know, that's the busiest skirt on Broadway. And I said, I learned it from you. About a year and a half ago, I did a reading of Dear World, and we had a cast, Madeline Kahn, Deborah Monk, Alfred Molina, Audra McDonald, phenomenal cast, and CHITA. And that was another incredible experience, because I was actually able to work with her for 2 weeks, and it was as close as perfection as one could get. She's a phenomenal dancer, a phenomenal singer, but she is a great actress. Great actress. And it is only my wish that I would have that experience all over again. Any day I'll put skates back on to work with you. Any day. So, after having been one of CHITA's boys a while ago, it is now my pleasure to now introduce another set of CHITA boys.
Starts to shimmy while her bottom says, give me. When her shoulder goes pop, 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 and her head starts to pop, roll, pop, roll, pop, roll, while her bottom says, pop, roll, give me, pop, roll, give me, pop, roll. Pop, roll, gimme! CHITA!
Che ci lo dice da una?
Che ti pare tutti?
Risa!
Che quello? Dalla luna!
Diversión.
Como quisiera su, déjame enseñarte un
buen tiempo.
You know what I mean, Cheetah?
Hey there, Cheetah! Hey there, Cheetah! The minute you stepped on the stage, my extension starts to glow until it cannot get bigger. Your aura and your style, yeah, you have found a way to lay a slide in the aisle. And when you sing Blow, Gabriel, Blow, then we know you're going down in history.
You sure know where to put those Tonys, don't ya?
Yeah! Tony Stevens, Dan Lobono, Dennis Jones, Greg Butler, Desmond Richardson, Gary Schwartz, Richard Montoya, Rocco Verastique, and Gareth Valentine!
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our surprise guest, Miss Puerto Rico of 1949.
What's happening?
Oh.
This is working?
No. Oh, this is going to just screw up. Anyway, where was I? Oh, yeah, where are you?
Here I am.
Oh, hi, sit down. I'd like to thank the Drama League for bringing me here from Puerto Rico and for sending me back on a bus. Think about it. I first met Cheetah at the pageant. She was Miss Congeniality. Yeah, that's, you know, the nice one and the most popular and pretty much the most talented. But I won. It's funny how life turns out. I mean, Cheetah came to New York and became a big star. And not very much happened to me in Puerto Rico. Although not many people know it, but actually, I did the first workshop of West Side Story in Puerto Rico. Yeah. But the the Weislers didn't want to bring it in. So. Actually, Bajur was a huge success in Puerto Rico with me in it. But then, you know, it came here and she got the part, and well, everybody knows. Terrible. My love life hasn't been so hot either. I could have been the next Mrs. Xavier Cugat. But he married... Who got Cugat? Oh, yeah, yeah. Some puta. Which in English means Abby Lane. It's funny. I'm not bitter. I'm not sad. But somehow, good fortune has never shined upon me. Maestro, hit it. B flat. No, the other B flat. That's better. This life, this mean old life, ain't nothing for a girl, for a trusting girl. This life, this mean old life is full of care and woe. Everywhere I go, I give my heart away, but 5 will get you 10, it comes back again. Can't live in this old life, not for the life of me. Once I fell in love, well in love, but it did me no credit. First he said he'd forget me not, then forgot that he said it. So I wrote a note, quote, I'm yours, but the skunk never read it. That's the cheating kind of a guy women find in this old life. But this life, this mean old life, nothing for a girl, for a trusted girl.
This life, this mean old life is
full of caring world.
I work alone.
I give my
heart away,
but 5 will get you 10. It comes back again.
Why don't you go find a parade?
This old life.
You are extremely tall.
I'm so full of trust, I could bust for some guy to be.
Why don't you get on a float?
Someone desperately like a well-oiled machine in this machine.
Why don't you get the hell off the stage? Where is there a guy with an arm I'd be proud to be seen? Someone with a heart, very smart, that a lady could lean on.
Everywhere I go,
I'm so
full of my heart.
I could bust for a guy to be keen on. Can't live in this old life. Watch.
I do all my own choreography.
Oh
God, I'm too good for this show. Can't live.
And gentlemen, currently starring in the hit revival of Annie Get Your Gun opposite Reba McEntire, Brent Barrett.
Howdy, how y'all doing tonight? I'm just tickled pink to be here. I guess I've been hanging around Reba a little too long. I hear laughter and there's no... Well, I guess we've covered that too. I have never had the pleasure of working with CHITA RIVERA, but she's been a big influence in my life. The first Broadway show I saw on Broadway was Chicago, and I was hoping that I would be able to stay around the Schubert long enough to see her Roxy Hart dance across the stage, but alas. But we do have one thing in common, and that's this next song. About 10 years ago, I was doing workshop production of The World Goes Round, the whole theater in New Jersey. And CHITA came out to see the show. And I was told that after that, she decided to do Kiss of the Spider Woman. Now, that's probably a big fat lie, but it made me really happy. So, here we go. Sooner or later, you're certain to meet in the bedroom, the parlor, or even the street. There's no place on earth you're likely to miss a kiss. Sooner or later, in sunlight or gloom, when the red candles flicker, she'll walk through the room, and the curtain will shake, and the fire will hiss. Here comes her kiss, and the moon grows dimmer at the tide's low ebb, and her black beads shimmer, and you're aching to move, but you're caught in the web of the Spider-Woman. With her velvet cape, you can scream, but you cannot escape. Sooner or later, your love will arrive, and she touches your heart. You're alert and alive, and there's only one pin that can puncture such bliss. A kiss. Sooner or later, you bathe in success, and your minions salute. They say nothing but yes, but your power is empty. It fades like the mist.
Once you've been kissed and the moon grows dimmer at the tide's low ebb, and your breath comes faster and you're aching to move, but you're caught in the web of the spider woman with a velvet cape. You can run, you can scream, you can hide, but you cannot escape. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the author of West Side Story, Gypsy, The Way We Were, The Turning Point, and currently directing Chita Rivera in Valencia at the George Street Playhouse, Arthur Lawrence.
Is this on? I met Chita during West Side Story, and over the years, there's hardly a day when somebody doesn't come up to one of us and say how their lives were changed by West Side Story, which they saw when they were three. Actually, her life and my life were both changed in obvious ways by that show, but in one that is more meaningful and more important and that most people don't know. We became friends. We're still friends. We are closer friends now than we ever were, because among her talents is a gift for friendship. Very few people have it, even less these very self-centered days, but she has it. She is a true friend and a marvelous friend. And right now, we are having, well, at least I am, the best time I've had in years with her. Last year, I saw a play in Buenos Aires called, forgive the correction, Venecia. And I was so captivated by it, I adapted it, and I'm now directing it at the George Street Playhouse in New Jersey with Chita in the starring role. She is an old-fashioned star. By that I mean she's not a diva, she's a leader. She leads the company with her talent, with her work ethic, with her professional, with her pastries and bagels that she's too disciplined to eat, and the rest of them stuff themselves on it. But she knows how to work. I knew, because I directed great ladies of the theater and musicals like Angela Lansbury and Tyne Daly, that Chita was a great musical comedy performer. And she was right up there with them. I've also directed great ladies of legitimate theater like Kim Stanley and Jane Fonda and Eileen Heckert. And I did not know that Chita is right up there with them. She is an absolutely superb actress. I don't think anyone in this room has any idea how good she is, and you won't until you come see the play. She is extraordinary. And guess what she's playing? A blind old whore. It's a character part. I said at the beginning that West Side Story changed our lives. Chita changed the life of West Side Story in London. We were supposed to open, but we had a delay 6 months. While the producer insisted on waiting for Chita, who was having a child. And that delay is here now, tonight. She is the lovely, the delightful Lisa Mordenti.
Thank you. tall. Hi. You really have to understand the stress at this moment. Can I just take 1 second before I start this song? I don't know where to start from all the amazing things that you've already seen, but just from the video in the beginning. That was Chita Rivera, okay? There's this entity, this person, Chita Rivera. And, but I have this mommy, see? And those are two different people, and that's what she taught me growing up. And it was just the two of us. And I have a blessed childhood, blessed. I got to, you know, when mama would go on tour with Sweet Charity, she'd say, okay, well, you know, tonight, I know you've said, let me put you over, go over to Fiddler on the Roof and sit in the orchestra pit. Fiddler on the Roof? You know, Britney Spears, hello? You know, I was blessed to be able to see a lot of things at such a young age, and Mama always taught me to separate the two. So I had this amazing woman. And at 4:30, we would have dinner at home, you know, plates, no TV, talking, life. And then 7:30, half hour. Two different people. So, you know, she gave me an incredible understanding of what this is all about. You must separate the two. Never the twain shall meet. And I must tell you, with all the people that are here tonight, you know, I've been in LA, folks. It ain't the same. These lights are not as bright. It's different, and it's so wonderful to be back, and it's wonderful to be back for my mommy. But there's Chita Rivera, and there's mommy. And those are two different people, and this one song I'm going to sing, if I can just get through it, is for my mommy. So if you'll just let me get this chair, I'll be... Oh, can't with this, Alan Cummings. Hello, L.A. Nay. Okay. Mama, I love you. It's for you.
When you feel afraid, when you lose your way, I will find you. Just try to smile and dry your eyes. I will bring back the moon into your skies. Whenever you will remember, darling, I'll be there to sing.
Mama, I'll be there just for you. Moving chair. Sorry. Mama, that was so amazingly just for you. And Kenny Loggins wrote that song. And he wrote it for his child. And God, it's so, I'll be there to sing for you. Yeah. Anyway, so osmosis. If anybody ever wondered about osmosis, I don't know, but, you know, I listened to West Side Story. I wasn't there, but I was here. And there's certain parts, you know, where people are just like holding hands in the score, and I go, I was so there. I was so there. And Arthur Lawrence introduced me. Oh. If it wasn't for him, I so would not be. Yeah. This is quite an evening. Now, I'm going to quickly, because I got to sing two songs. This particular song was written, and this is one of Mama's favorite songs. I got married 7 years ago. 7 years, oh. My husband, Donnie Kerr. Donnie wrote this song, and I get to sing it, and I get to sing it in my key. And I just want to introduce to you Kevin Kuhn on the guitar. Tommy, oh. Michael Orland, musical director right there. And if it wasn't for Michael Orland, I would not be up here, because he made me start singing again. Anyway, rambling, singing Song of Donnie's.
I've seen so many just like you. You let your promise go to shame. You think the world is out to get you. Your frame of mind's to blame. Don't bring me into your nightmares. Your dreams are just like mine. Don't let life pass you by. Just breathe in deep and close your eyes. And never say die, never say die, never say die. Never say die, never say die, never say die. I've seen dark clouds above you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the choreographer, director for such shows as Kiss of the Spider-Woman, Little Me, the current hit revival of Cabaret, and the upcoming film version of Chicago, Rob Marshall.
Lisa, that was so beautiful. That was so gorgeous, so touching. What a talent. A major talent. First of all, I was told I should say a quick thank you to Rob Bowman and this amazing trio. So, come on, guys. Extraordinary. I have a quick little story about Cheetah. It was sort of the greatest night of my life and sort of a horrible one as well, because I met Cheetah doing the rink in 1983, and I was the dance captain and understudy. And so I was going on for the first time, and I was a nervous wreck. And I think Cheetah remember this well. And she was so great to me, so supportive. And I remember going on stage, and Fred Ebb said to me before I went on, he said, just don't hurt my star, okay? And I thought, oh God, I'm gonna die. I was so nervous and such a wreck. And Cheetah started, we started dancing this fabulous jitterbug that Graziella Danielle choreographed. And we were dancing, and she kept saying, she looked me in the eye, and she, you could, when you dance with Cheetah, it's sort of an extraordinary experience because you feel her with you. She looks you in the eye, and she pulls you along. You know, it's a great thing. I notice when I've had dancers work with her, they always have to work to keep up to her level because she sets it. And it's, so I was experiencing that for the first time as just, you know, a kid. And she kept saying under her breath, breathe, 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 breathe. And she was right because I hadn't breathed once. And so I started breathing and she was so almost passed out. And and so we were finishing the number and we were winding up to do these Sinead turns, which were these turns that you do, like Carol Lawrence was sort of doing across there, back and forth, those fast, fast turns. And we were supposed to cross each other. And it was the finale of the number. And so I wound up to do it, and Cheetah did too. And we looked right at each other. We went at it, and we connected. You know, I hit her. I smacked her. I hit the woman. Bam, and which was not a good thing. And I could see Fred Ebb in the wings. I thought, that's it. It's all over. And we finished the number. Kaboom! And I landed on my knees, and she's smiling, and she said, "I think you broke my finger." Under her breath, smile. "I think you broke my finger." And I had totally broken her finger, and she wore a splint on her finger for the next month. Never missed a show, never missed a show, which is Chita Rivera. Which is Chita Rivera. So Fred, I'm sorry, I'm so sorry, Fred. I feel so horrible, and Cheetah, you know. Anyway, I've had the great good fortune of working with Cheetah many times over the years, and to choreograph her and Kiss the Spider-Woman was something that's a dream come true, to be able to see your choreography. And it was my, once again, it was my debut on Broadway as a choreographer. So to have Cheetah Rivera dancing your steps, you can imagine. You can imagine. And somebody once said that when you're working with Cheetah in a room, you don't want to be anywhere else in the world. And that's how I feel. Anytime I'm with Cheetah, it's just, it's that experience. And anyway, she's a legend, a musical theater legend, and I know she hates hearing that, but she is. And I have the great honor to introduce two other incredible legends who also hate hearing that they are, but they've played such a huge role in Cheetah's life, and both of her Tonys were won in their shows. The extraordinary and amazing and sweetest gentleman in the world, and the honorary chairs this evening, Mr. John Kander and Fred Ebb. He said, "Put it in the thing, Rob. Put it in the thing."
Gee, if you ever didn't believe I loved you, think about tonight, because I feel like shit. And but I got out of my sick bed, and I put on my Ralph Lauren $4,500 tuxedo and stud and stuff, and I came out, Cheat, and I'm here, Cheat. And this afternoon, I had a fever, and my collaborator called me and said, "Fred, have you got a fever?" And I said, "John, if it goes up one more point, sell." I did. Anyway, I was going to sing from The Rink. Remember that? You won a Tony, we got nothing. And I don't think I could get through it, so screw that. I'm glad that Elaine Stritch said fuck, because that's very liberating for people that come on after her. So here, I can say whatever I want, can I? You want to see my shoes from Ralph Lauren? Also, oh God, I bought it because it was on sale. 1% off. So I went over there, and let's see. I ought to sing something, even though I feel terrible, and I've come out. I don't like wearing this stuff either. You know who dressed me? My doorman. I swear to God, I couldn't put these things in. $5,000. And so I called downstairs, and Joe, I said, "Can you come up here and fix my studs?" So he said, "Yes, Mr. Rapp." I gave him $10. Cheetah, it's not been a good day, but I'm glad they're honoring you because you're swell, kiddo. And you're one of my best friends in life, and I'm crazy about you. I really am. And this fall, Johnny and I wrote still another play. And it's called The Visit, and it will open in Chicago. Yeah, at the Goodman Theater. And I'm going to sing you one of the songs from that, because I can't hit New York, New York. And that's the truth. And so... It's funny how you get up here, you just tell the truth about everything. Oh God, Cheat, I could really lay you low. But I won't. I pretend I don't know anything. And this lady in The Visit is sitting in a forest, and she has seen a lot in her life. She's grown a little tough, a little mean, and a little vengeful. And she meets a pair of young lovers. And when they leave, she's left alone. And it starts to snow. And she starts to think about life. When you're young, feeling oh so strong, what can prove you wrong? Love and love alone. When the sun seems forever bright, what can dim its light? Love
and love alone. So beware, young love, lost in a kiss. There's a truth, young love, simple as this. Every fond hello ends in goodbye. What seems certain to live will die. So enjoy all the time there is. If you're his, be his. Make each day your own. When tomorrow comes and your heart is stone, what has made you numb? Love and love alone. Da-da-dum. Da-da-dum.
Ladies and gentlemen, Liza Minnelli.
Thank you. Oh my goodness, Freddie, I'm on a stage again. It feels so strange. Only for Cheetah would I do this, because I'm so scared. Freddie, I feel exactly like you do. Cheetah once told me that you have to do exactly what you want and just kind of hide it from everybody, but be clear and do what you want, not what you think is right or what you think is this, but live your life. And Cheetah, this may sound maudlin, I'm sorry, I don't mean it to, but having nearly died, I can't tell you how many times I thought of you and how much you ran through my mind and my heart. Now, I didn't know I was going to be here because I really slipped out of something. I was supposed to go back tonight to Florida to this hospital that I have to be in for a while. And I told them that I couldn't, I had a cold, so that I could be here. So I lied for the first time since my death thing. I think I'll call it that, my death thing. You know? Cheating. All right, Freddie, you're gonna hate this. But I can't see without this. I sent you a telegram, Cheetah, because I really thought that I wouldn't be able to be here. But I'm here. So I'll read you my telegram. For you, Cheats. I just said, "Dear Cheetah, when I was 12 years old, our family moved to New York. And for my 13th birthday, my mother took me out for a night on the town, just the two of us. It was phenomenal. My surprise present from her was you. She took me to see Bye Bye Birdie, just the two of us. It was one of the greatest things that ever happened to me. You see, let me get back to my own telegram. I said it better. I'm rambling, Freddie, I'm sorry. Let me see, I'm gonna start again. Okay, when I was 12 years old, our family moved to New York, And for my 13th birthday, my mom took me out for a night on the town, just the two of us. My surprise present for her, from her, was you. Two on the Isle. The show was Bye Bye Birdie. She said you were the best in the business, and I felt like I'd been hit by a hurricane. That night, you changed my entire life. I promise you, you did, Chita. Through the years, you have continued to absolutely astonish me with your exquisite talent, your unabashed bravery, and the purest, most silken talent I have ever seen on any stage. You are still my hero, my mentor, my challenge. But now, you are one of my dearest friends, and the abundance and generosity of your friendship outweighs even your talent. Congratulations, my darling, Liza. CHITA, I love you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, Anne Reinking.
You wanna know something? I always wanted my name in the papers. Before Amos, I used to date this wealthy, well-to-do, ugly bootlegger. He used to like to dress me up and take me out and show me off. Ugly guys like to do that. Once it said in the paper, Gangland's Al Capelli seen at Shea Vito with cute Corrine. That was me. I clipped it out and I saved it. Now look, Roxy rocks Chicago. Oh yeah. Look, I'm gonna tell you the truth. Not that the truth really matters, but I'm gonna tell you anyway. You see, the thing is, I'm older than I ever intended to be. And all my life I wanted to be a dancer in vaudeville, oh yeah. Have my own act. But no. 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 No, 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 no. It was one great big world. Amos came along. Sweet, safe Amos. Who never says no. You know, some guys are like mirrors. And when I see myself in Amos's face, I'm always a kid. You could love a guy like that. Now look, I'm gonna tell you something, and I hope this ain't too crude. But in the bed department, Amos was zero.
And then when he went back to me, I mean, I don't know, it was like he was trying to fix a carburetor or something. I love you, honey, I love you. Ooh. Anyway, to make a long story short, I started fooling around. Then I started screwing around, which is fooling around without dinner. Think about it. Anyway, I gave up the vaudeville idea because I figure, well, after all these years, opportunity passed me by. Oh, why did I? Oh, no. And with all this publicity, I could still get me into vaudeville. I could still have my own act. Now I got me. One great big world full of yes. The name on everybody's lips is gonna be Roxy, the lady raking in the chips is gonna be Roxy. I'm gonna be a celebrity. That means somebody everyone knows. Yeah. They're gonna recognize my eyes, my hair, my teeth, my boobs, my nose. From just some dumb mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be Roxy, who says that murder's not an art, and who, in case she doesn't hang, can say she started with a bang. Roxy Hart. Oh, yeah, I'm gonna have me a swell act too, yeah. Y'all get me a boy to work with. You know, someone who can lift me up and show me off. Oh, hell, I'll get two boys. It will frame me better. Oh, think big, Roxy. Think big. I'm gonna get me bunch of boys. Hi. The name on everybody's lips is gonna be
Roxy.
The lady raking in the chips is gonna be. Yeah.
She's gonna be a celebrity.
That means somebody everyone knows.
They're gonna recognize her eyes, her hair, her teeth,
my boobs, my nose. Ooh. From just some dumb mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be singing
Roxy.
Who says that murder's not an art? And who, in case she doesn't hang, can say she started with a bang? Oh. see an olive beer and a warm beer that goes all the way down to my waist. The audience for loving me, and they love me for loving them, and I love them for loving me. Oh, we just love each other. That's because none of us ever got enough love in our childhood.
That's right.
And that's show business.
Oh, oh yeah. She's giving us her humdrum life.
I'm gonna be
Roxy. She made a scandal. I'm a star.
For coming tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I just wanted to tell you that there are a lot of singer, dancer, actresses who have been blessed to follow in Cheetah's footsteps, blessed to follow into the footsteps of the two women who created this show, starred in it. They didn't create it, John and Bob and Fred did. But they starred in it and they put their creative energies into it and made it so special. Made all of us a little bit braver. Happy to breathe hard and give it our all and say at the end of the performance, this is really a hard way to make a living. But then I see Cheetah dance and I go, God, I just want to do that. And it's kind of a sickness, but I can't thank you enough for getting me all sick like this. We are very happy to follow in your footsteps. We're happy to thank the beautiful Gwen Verdon. Most wonderful, naughty, talented, fun-loving, real smart, very chic, real sassy. Everything I'm trying to be right now. And it's with a great deal of sincerity, Cheetah Rivera, you are the best looking gal in the whole darn room. I mean, we're just all wearing our skirts really short up here because we're threatened. They always say the legs are the last to go. Whew, thank goodness. Anyway, it's with nothing but sincerity that we sing this song. It's good, isn't it grand?
E.B. Newark!
Great, isn't it swell?
Belle Calloway!
Isn't it fun, isn't it? Nowadays.
Sandy Duncan, Mamie Duncan Gibbs, and Karen Zia.
what's good is a hit grand, is a hit great, is a hit swell, is a hit fun, is a hit, but nothing stays. In 50 years or so, it's gonna change, you know.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Who were they talking about? I don't know that person. I just know that I want to thank God. I really do, because I'm telling you, I'm so lucky. I see myself. I see like a tapestry, you know, like I'm born like a painting, say, and my picture. My picture, it's born with a red heart, you know, but the rest of it is empty. And my colors are you all. My experiences, my friendships, my respect, I am so grateful for the life that I have. I also see myself as, it's funny to sit out front and have people do things like this for you. I'm so used to being here that it was very uncomfortable because I'm used to standing up and whistling, and I got myself all dressed up and tried to act like a girl, but like a lady. But I also have this image of like workhorse and carriage, and I'm usually the workhorse, which I am very happy to be, the one that is up here. And I'm not in the carriage very often, but tonight I was the carriage. I was the girl. And I am grateful for the Drama League for honoring me like this. I am truly grateful because it's what I love, love, love to do. It's my gift that God gave me. I don't know what it is. I look and see you all. Do doing what you're doing and saying that I did that, and that's nice. I didn't know. I just have been lucky to have great friends, great choreographers and directors and authors and lyricists and composers. I came along at a great time, and I was able to do these shows. I thank my friends so much. You're all so beautiful. And Freddie, I'm not going on too long, am I? Yes, you said dirty words tonight, Freddie. He would never allow me or Liza to do that. And my baby Lisa is here. So I will get off, but I just want to thank everybody, you all, for coming here and honoring me like this and making it such a beautiful, beautiful evening. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. And I haven't stopped dancing yet. The arthritis is going to stop me. But it hasn't hit yet. So as long as it still moves, ladies, as long as it still moves, keep it going. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Dancing yet.